the previous video, we saw how to design a proportional controller for the desired angular position. In this video, we want to verify the open loop transfer function which we got from the experiment 1. So, to be precise, I want to calculate the closed loop, I want to find the transfer function of the closed loop system which we got from the second experiment. So, when I identified that closed loop system, from that I will extract the open loop transfer function. So, we'll start with the experiment. So, till now we know that from the second experiment, we have designed a KP and for this open loop transfer function. So, till now we know that we have designed a KP to achieve desired angular position. So, we know that this angular position which gave was a 180 degree, which is not a function of time. So, this kind of problem is called as a set point problem. So, when this theta is function of time, then we call this problem as a tracking problem. So, which is nothing but whatever I give as input, my output should track the input. So, that is why this particular when the desired angular position is function of time is called as a tracking problem. So, this the aim of this particular experiment is to find the transfer function of closed loop system using Bode plot. So, this is very similar to the first experiment. So, in the first experiment, to calculate k and alpha, we sent the sine wave as an input and collected the output, which is also a sine wave, and from that we plotted the magnitude plot, and from that we got the cutoff frequency. So, from this we got the transfer function. Similarly, we will do this for closed loop system. Here I will send a sine wave, and since the closed loop system is also a LTI system, so which I explained in the first experiment. During the first experiment, that LTI system is a linear time invariant system, that is like if I give a input which is sine and I will expect a output is also sine, but with some phase shift and a scaled. So, for example, if input is A sine omega t, output will be A2 sine omega t plus some phi, which is a phase shift. So, the same thing holds true for the closed loop system. So this is the aim of the experiment. So, we know that the closed loop transfer function is equal to Kp into 12. This is the closed loop system, so which we already know, and we also designed the KP, and we will have the closed loop system. But now we want to know practically, I mean this is a theoretical transfer function for the closed loop system. So now we want to know, so now we assume that we do not know the open loop transfer function. That is this thing k by s into s plus alpha. We assume that this we do not know, and from that we know that this will be k p, the closed loop system will be k p k s into s plus alpha plus k p k. So this can be written as k p k by s into s plus alpha by 1 plus k p k s plus alpha. So from this what I mean to say is, if I know the closed loop system, a closed loop transfer function, from that I can extract the open loop transfer function. So that is our goal. So before going to the demonstration, I will explain the logic, and the logic is very similar to the first experiment. So what I do is again select the port to which motor is connected, so I will generate a sine wave as an input. So the input would be 180 into sine omega t, which is nothing but 180 angle, and it will be like something like this. So my desired angular position will vary as a sine wave. So then I will start the timer, and I will run this for 10 seconds, and my desired angle is 180 degree into sine omega t. I will calculate the error, which is theta t and actual angular position. So, and I will drive the motor by sending this kp into error term. So, this will be the input to the motor. So, this is how I do the experiment. So, now we will go to the code. So this is very similar to the first experiment. So as I said, the eta which I take is 0.5, and which will create a kp, and I will set the motor initially the angular position of the motor is set to 0, and I will start the timer. So as I said, it will run for 10 seconds, and this is how it is done. And as I in the first experiment I explained why we take the weight as 10, which is nothing but to say about sampling frequency. So if I give a delay of 10 millisecond, which is nothing but I am collecting the samples at every 10 millisecond gap, which is nothing but 100 hertz of sampling frequency. It will be approximate sampling frequency, and which is sufficient for this experiment, because the operation frequency are
in 1 hertz to 10 hertz as I said earlier. So, now I am printing T angle and desired angle, desired angular positions. So, if I run this code, so as we can see that the motion of the motor is very smooth, which says that the gain of the system is very high. The ratio of the input and output is 1. So, when the frequency is 0.6 hertz, the motor rotates faster, but it is not as smooth as before. When the frequency of operation is 8 hertz, it is barely moves. It says that the magnitude ratio of output versus input is very low. So, I will paste here. So, this Python code is very similar to what we did in the experiment 1. So, I will briefly explain, which is nothing. First, we will plot the angular position versus time, and next we will plot the Bode plot of the magnitude Bode plot. So, when I run this code, so we will get input and output plot. So, actually before running this code, we have to run this load file. This is to be done to store the values, the magnitude and frequency values. So, when I run this code, so we get input and output. As we can see, it is very clear from the closed loop system at very low frequencies. It is run at, so we can see here that the frequency of operation is 0.3 hertz. So, for a closed loop system, which is the gain, DC gain is 1. So, which is evident from this figure that the output and input, the magnitude ratio of output and input are 1. So, when I do this for every frequency like 0.3, 0.4, 0.5 as I did in the first experiment and plot the Bode plot, I will get the Bode plot as like this. And this is by I have stored the values. So, from that I get the magnitude Bode plot. As we expect that there is hump at the cutoff frequency, and if we see this, and I have already did using line tools, I have already calculated what is the cutoff frequency. So, from this we see that the cutoff frequency is at 10 radius per second. So, from this we can get the closed loop system. So, from the graph, we know that there exists a 40 dB decay. So, this hump is because of eta, which is a 0.5, and it is at 10 radian per second. So, we know that closed loop system is given by so, when we substitute these values, we will get 100 divided by S square plus 100, and if we
do the same thing for when kp and from theoretical results we know that it should be kp 1257 divided by s square plus 12.57 s into kp 1257. So here the kp for this particular eta is 0.12, as I said earlier. So if I substitute here, so we will get around 150. So, which is comparable. So, from this we will get a cutoff frequency of 10 by 2 pi, which is around 1.7, which is around 1.6. So, from this we got 2 hertz. And from this we got 1.6 hertz, so which is almost same. So, so the goal of this experiment was to identify the closed loop system, which we identified from the Bode plot. So, thank you.